Honorable Minister in absentia and Professor Menon in absentia, Shri Rao, Dr. Narayanan, Ravi, Sandeep, all the other distinguished members, participants, delegates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. And I'll try and extend a warm welcome. It's not a warm morning, but you know, we can certainly do with a warm welcome. I must at the outset also thank the organizers for providing myself and the organization an opportunity to present some of our thoughts. I must congratulate Ravi on, you know, thinking up of a very aspirational theme for discussion. I have seen a lot of these faces which are right now in the audience at several other forums in different e-governance conferences, where a lot of discussions have happened around, you know, urban reforms, cities, municipalities, and most of them have focused around citizen services and very little on urban development. And this is probably the first time I'm seeing a very aspirational theme behind what CSDMS and Ravi has put up. And in fact, that was one of the key reasons when, you know, we also, when we are trying to support an event, we also try and do some of our own justifications and rationalization of our association. And that was one of the key things that we looked at, that here is an aspirational discussions, and we as an organization want to be a part of that aspiration of becoming smart cities, and you know, how we could help you know, the country in that aspiration in our own limited way, which is primarily from an ICT perspective. Now, having said that, you know, I what comes to my mind, this is the year of Commonwealth Games. All of us know that, and you know, you have seen a lot of controversies, you've seen a lot of euphoria, you've seen a lot of exasperation, you've seen officials coming and feeling satisfied about the goings-on. Still, there is a lot of paranoia about, you know, whether we are going to achieve the milestones, whether the construction is going to be completed, etc., etc. It's all about, you know, how we have planned, what we have done, and what we are able to, what we are going to be able to deliver. In the year of games, if I am to think of an aspirational statement as to where we may want to be as a smart city, what I can think of is probably trying to host the Olympics, and which has also gone through a round of, you know, controversies earlier. And we've heard the sports minister saying that we should not be hosting Olympics because, you know, it is an enormous drain on funds and resources, and we are not prepared, and you know, we may not have credibility. Now, I don't intend getting into any of those controversies, but I just want to draw out a few you know, characteristics and a few things that happen in this entire process. The Olympics of 2016 has already been awarded, as most of you would know. You know, Rio is going to host. They won against Chicago and Madrid and a couple of other cities, and Olympics is going to be hosted in 2016 at Rio. So what's really open as a choice, if at all, you know, for the country, is the 2020 Olympics, okay, which is very clearly 10 years away. Beijing did the Olympics in 2008, as most of you are aware of. You know, the last Olympics was Beijing, China. You know, so that itself tells us a difference of about 12 odd years between China and India in terms of, you know, where smart cities are likely to be, irrespective of the controversies which could be there around, you know, Beijing Olympics and so on. So, you know, the earliest aspirational smart city endeavor to be able to host an Olympic Games is about, you know, 10 years away. But the question is that, are we even looking at the 2020 Olympics? Because, you know, the process for evaluation of the city for the choice of 2020 Olympics is going to start in about a year. If any of you are aware of the cycle of, award. It's a very, very detailed process of selection, and the selection is done about 7 years before the city is going to host the Olympics, and the process of that selection starts about 9 years before. So there is about 1.5 to 2 years which is spent on the selection of the city which is going to host the Olympics. It's a 2 to 3 tier process. There are applicant cities, so cities can apply, and there are these bid documents which are there, which run into. I've seen the Chicago bid documents, and that runs into about 45 to 50 MB zip files, actually. So you can imagine the amount of data and volume and discussions that happen in these bid documents. So there are these applicant cities out of which the International Olympic Committee selects the eligible cities to go forward in the selection process. Out of the applicant cities, they draw out about 4, 5, 6 candidate cities, and then these candidate cities go through various rounds of elimination process or voting process, which happens in the IOC sessions. And the final city which is awarded must get a 50% majority vote before getting selected. It's a very, very elaborate and a complex process, and obviously everything about city being smart goes into that evaluation process. And broadly, if you see, I was trying to lay my hands in, on what are the specific parameters which this committee looks at, which is going to define the smart city and therefore that city getting selected. It is not easy to find that unless you actually go into that process and have some surveys around that. But if you look at the Olympics Charter, which basically guides that selection, it talks about infrastructure, and of course infrastructure is all inclusive across every area. It talks about stability. Now, stability is basically in terms of the population, the growth of population, and the safety and security around that particular city, and of course the resources or the capability to bring in resources to be able to host that. These are three key dimensions around which a city evaluation happens in the initial stages when a city is moving from becoming an applicant city to a candidate city. This is, now you might be wondering as to why I've highlighted so much. This is not to, get into any debate on whether, we should be looking at hosting Olympics or giving our candidature for Olympics in 2020 or beyond that. This is certainly not a suggestion on that or an exercise in trying to initiate any debate on that. This is also not to say that, there has to be a one-time momentum or infusion not a regular visit to creating a smart city. None of these is what I'm alluding to. All that I'm alluding to is to, draw out some of the key characteristics of a smart city from this entire process. Number one, that it's a very, very long-term planning process. We are not going to be converting into a smart city over 1 year or 2 year or even 5 years. It's a very long drawn out process. If preparedness for Olympics, and if you look at the life cycle, as I said, 7 to 9 years, selection process, and then within those 7 years there is foundational planning, there is operational planning, there is closer to games operational planning, and so on, for which the time periods are defined, 5.5 years, 3 years, and so on and so forth. If for that situation there is a 7-year to 9-year planning that we need to do, obviously if we want to create sustainability around smartness of cities, not just one-time smartness, you set up all the network for games and then it disappeared, but the sustainability of that, obviously it takes a lot of effort, it takes a lot number of years, and that's what I'm trying to bring to the table, that administrators, government, and all the other visionaries and